Hi everyone, Aaron here for Zolotech, an iOS 16 public beta and beta 3 re-release, as well as iOS 15.6 release candidate 2, have been out for a few days, almost a full business week at this point, and there's even more features that I wanted to talk about. We'll also talk about the overall reliability, stability, battery life, and more a little bit later when it comes to these particular betas, and we'll also talk about when to expect their public release. But first, let's talk about new features. Now, I mentioned the other day that YouTube Picture-in-Picture is rolling out to everyone. I won't go into everything about it, but it's enabled in the US for free. It's rolling out slowly. When you're playing a video, you can just swipe up, and now you've got Picture-in-Picture where you can resize it and more. Unfortunately, it's available to premium users rolling out around the world and isn't available everywhere just yet. Hopefully they make this free everywhere, as it's already available free to Android users and has been for a while. Now on the lock screen, there's a couple things I wanted to mention that I haven't before. So if we go to the lock screen and then we press and hold and then we customize, when you tap on an area, it actually flashes when you go to highlight it, what you're actually selecting. So maybe we want to change this widget area here. You'll see the overall ring is sort of flashing a little bit. That was there in beta 2 as well, it seems, but it's something I didn't mention. Also on the lock screen, I mentioned with the beta 3 re-release and public beta, we now have the music widget and its content will show up on the home screen or the lock screen if you tap on the image. And you can see it even works within YouTube. So if you tap on the image, tap away from it, it goes away. And if you want to go to that app, tap on the title and it will bring you back to the app. The same is true when we go into maybe music here. We'll just hit play briefly and then we'll go home, go to our lock screen or notifications, and you'll see it there. And the nice thing is the background changes with whatever's on the display. So if we change albums, you'll see that it's actually changing the background to match. It's a really nice touch, especially when it's on the lock screen. Maybe you're just listening to music. You can see that here. If you want it to go away, just tap on it and then scroll up for your notifications. So it's really nice that that's been added and it's finally here. I showed it a little bit before, but this is something Apple's been promising since the initial release of iOS 16. So it's great to see it here. Also, iOS 16 is adding AVIF support. That's a newer codec for different photos and things, and it supports transparency, wide color gamut, HDR, and animated images. So it could actually replace GIFs or GIFs. Also, it's already supported by things like Mozilla Firefox and Google Chrome. So it's great that they're adding it here to Safari as a standard. So those images will now work as far as AVIF photo files. Now within the Stocks app, there's a new feature, and I haven't seen this before. This was sent in by Thomas, so thanks for sending this. And if there's an earnings report coming up, you'll actually have the option to add it to a calendar. So you can see here, you put the little pointer to show us where it is, but you can add to calendar and it seems to work now. So if there's an earnings report coming up, it will show in the Stocks app. It's a nice little thing they've added. With accessibility, we have some new features. They were also in beta 2, but I haven't mentioned these before. And if we go into settings, go to accessibility, scroll down, you'll see here we have accessibility shortcuts. That's been there for a while, but we have some new options, such as Apple Watch mirroring, control nearby devices, and live captions, all new features. So if we go to the home screen, triple click our button on the side, our silent sleep wake button, you'll see we get some options and we can pick from what we want. So we can use live captions here and Apple Watch mirroring, but also control nearby devices. And it picks up that we have iOS 16 devices nearby, iPhone 11 and iPad Pro. So we'll pick iPhone 11. It takes a moment and now we can control it. So you'll see here it says connected. And if I bring this in, we can see our options here with the menu. So we have home, we have app switcher, notification center, control center, and Siri, and then our media playback options, as well as volume up and down. So if we go back here and maybe go here, we'll go into the control center. If we tap on this button, we'll go into multitasking. If we tap on home, we'll go home. And then we also have Siri. So these are some nice options that I haven't seen before. And it's built in, so we can easily go into accessibility by triple clicking our silent sleep wake button. That's something really great that they've added and makes it much more convenient if you regularly use those features. Within the home app, if we go to our button in the upper right for menus, and then we go to Home Settings, if we scroll down, you'll see Software Update. If we go to Software Update, you have HomePod Beta Updates. This wasn't showing up for me before, and it's been there for a little while, but you'll see the HomePod Beta Updates, and you can just enable those with a switch. So this was in previous betas, but it wasn't showing up for me. Now it is. So we could just turn this on to any HomePod we want to change. When you go into your settings and go to iCloud and then go to sign up for iCloud Plus, which I already have, some people are actually seeing a new splash screen. And it looks like this, where it says more storage and powerful new features, and then it gives you the storage plans, such as 200 gigabytes or 2 terabytes. So I'm actually not seeing this, but if you are, let me know in the comments below. Now, I wanted to share some changes with the Apple Watch as well. So if you've got your Apple Watch on a charger or you're about to charge it and it's really low, it actually has a new screen that it shows. So if we go back into Photos, I have a screenshot. Within Photos, and thanks to Clayton for sending this along, the overall screen will be completely red instead of just the little battery status indicator itself. So I haven't seen this myself as I haven't run the battery down, but if you do and it goes really low, it will actually show that it's completely red now. So that's something a little bit different. And then also if you're in sleep mode, so maybe we go into sleep here, let's go down and let's just change this and we'll go into sleep. And when we're in sleep mode, if this is off our wrist, and so we'll just set it down like this, turn it on, and you'll see we're in sleep mode. If you want to get out of this, I'll put in my password. If I want to get out of this, I can hold the crown down and you'll get a new animation. It says keep holding and then it will pop out of sleep mode. So that's something a little bit new. Now, something else I wanted to mention, but wanted to reiterate that I think Apple will bring back, but isn't here with beta 3, is the option for, if we go into settings, go down to Siri and search, we no longer have the Siri call hangup option. So this is gone. Hopefully they bring it back with future updates. Sometimes they do this with betas where they remove a feature because there's a problem, they fix it and put it back in. So we'll look for that with beta 4. Also, one thing that's a little bit funny that I wanted to share with you is in this update, there's something as far as bugs go, but this is a bug unlike we normally see. If we go into our settings and then go down to our name here or tap on our name at the top, under iCloud and then password and keychain, tap on that, and you'll see here it actually has a spelling mistake where it says secularly instead of securely store your passwords. So this is still a beta. There's definitely some bugs, but there's a spelling error there as well. And I just thought I'd share that as it's a little bit odd. We don't see that too often. Now, as far as bugs in iOS 16 public beta and beta 3 re-release, well, voice dictation is buggy sometimes, especially if you're using CarPlay, it can cut in and out, or if you're just maybe dictating email or something else, it can just shut off or get it really wrong. It has improved quite a bit with beta 3, but it still has some issues. I'm still having issues with iMessage group conversations where sometimes the text entry box is completely gone again. I continue to have that on beta 3. Sometimes it comes back, sometimes it goes away, and that's true not only on my iPhone, but also the iPad as well. It goes back and forth. It's really odd, and if I need to reply to someone, I typically have to go to my Mac, and then I can reply to a message thread. I only see that on group conversations, though. Setting wallpapers is much better in this one, but music is still randomly stopping for some. So if you're playing some songs, sometimes they just stop randomly. I'm hearing that from quite a few people. We had that in earlier iOS 15 betas and public versions, and now it's back with this beta. So they definitely need to fix that. Also, apps are still crashing for some. Instagram is an example. Also, TikTok is crashing for some when they're sharing a video or just crashing in general. And some banking apps are still not working. And so there's definitely some issues. Also, some accessibility apps are having some issues with things such as VoiceOver and Live Captions. Now, to be fair, Live Captions is still in beta, but I've seen it not work at all. So if you're using Live Captions, just keep that in mind. If you have accessibility needs here that are not working properly, that could be an issue. So definitely don't use the beta just yet. Now, as far as the phone getting too warm or very hot, I really haven't experienced that too much. It's much better than beta 2. Some people are saying they are experiencing that still, but most report it's better than beta 2 and especially beta 1. So definitely an improvement there. Now, as far as iOS 15.6, the good thing is that's coming very soon and seems to be incredibly stable for iOS 15. Of course, this late in the game, we should have a very stable version, so RC2 should be the final public version. We really haven't seen an RC3 on iPhone. I think we had one on the Mac some time ago. but we haven't had it on iPhone. It seems to be quite stable, very few issues, if any, and much better battery life. So it seems to be much, much better. I shared the battery life a little while ago, and people seem to easily get through the day on this. So battery life overall is quite good for most people that are using 15.6. No complaints there, and most people say it's quite good. There are exceptions to that, but the majority so far seems to think it's pretty good that way. We'll talk about when to expect that in a moment, but as far as battery life on iOS 16 Beta 3, it's definitely better than previous versions with Beta 2 or Beta 1, but again, it's a beta, so it's going to have some issues. But overall, seems to be okay. If we go into battery life and battery health, you'll see I'm at 100%. So this is probably the longest I've had a phone stay at 100%, and this has been my main phone since it released. So I've used this the most of any of my other phones. I know some people say, well, you test phones, of course you have 100%, but really I use those other phones for a few days to a week at most. And so the majority of the weeks throughout the year, I'm using this phone. And you can see the cycle count here using coconut battery on the Mac. So it's quite good there. If we take a look at the last 5 days, yesterday I had 2 hours and 7 minutes of screen on time. And again, this is a bug. It cleared out all of my battery usage for some reason. I'm not sure why it did that. I did have to hard reboot this, so maybe that's why, but it only kept the last few days. But so far, my battery is not great. 2 hours and 7 minutes of screen on time, 1 hour and 32 minutes of screen off time. I'm at 46% on my phone. Also, you'll see the day before, 3 hours and 52 minutes of screen on time, 2 hours and 26 minutes of screen off time, or screen off time, with about 70% usage. Now, someone else did send me their battery life, so we could take a look at that. And if we take a look at battery life that Abhishek sent in from his 11 Pro Max, you can see it's still not great. It's a beta, 4 hours and 26 minutes of screen on time, 1 hour and 4 minutes of screen off time, and about 60% of his usage overall, as far as the battery life. And again, the day before, he only was getting about 4 hours and 35 minutes of screen on time with over 75% usage. So still not great. Again, keep in mind it's a beta. Now, battery life on the iPad has been what it's been before. At this point, there could be an issue with it, but we'll go to settings and battery, and you'll see yesterday I had 5 hours and 43 minutes of screen on time. That's pretty typical, and I had 75 to 80% usage. Usually I can get about 5 to 6 hours of screen on time with this. So it's not bad, but again, it's not great. It should be getting closer to 10. Of course, this is a little bit older now. It's been through quite a few cycles, as you can see here. But as far as overall performance, it's been super smooth. No real issues for me on the iPad, other than sometimes issues within YouTube with resizing windows and inputting text. That seems to be an issue here. Other than that, I haven't really had any major crashes. Now, as far as when to expect iOS 15.6, well, at this point, I would expect it as soon as Monday or Tuesday. That makes a lot of sense. We had RC2. Typically, it will be Monday or Tuesday. It will release to the public, and then you'll just be able to install it. Of course, if you already have iOS 15.6 RC2, you just had it a little bit early. That's typically what Apple does. Now, as far as iOS 16 Public Beta 2 and iOS 16 Beta 4, which will be the same thing, those updates could be a little ways away. Last year, on June 30th, we saw the release of iOS 15 Public Beta and Beta 2 re-release. Then on July 14th, we had the next beta, so the public beta 2 and beta 3 for iOS 15. So we could be a couple weeks out still. We may not see it for maybe another week or so. However, we could see another release the following week. It just depends what Apple wants to do, but typically they wait a couple weeks, so it could be a little bit before we get that. But definitely look for iOS 15.6 this coming week. Now, as far as the YouTube community poll, let's take a look at that. We'll go into YouTube. Now, at the time of this video, you can see there's 12,000 votes. So thanks to everyone that voted, and there's 224 comments. Those are the issues I refer back to when talking about the overall stability that I mentioned earlier, whether there's issues or not. 39% of you are on the public beta or beta 3 re-release. Only 4% of you are using iOS 15.6, which doesn't really surprise me there. Almost 50%, 49% of you are on iOS 15.5 or older, 1% are still using iOS 14.8 or older, and 6% are using Android, whether that be Android 12, the beta, or a different version. Now let's take a look at a few comments. Now I picked out a few different comments randomly. Let's take a look at those. And the first one's from Jesse F. He said, "Hi Aaron, new viewer here. I've been running iOS 16 developer beta since the start. at first with an iPhone XR, which I then traded for an iPhone 13. Battery life definitely seems to have improved since I picked it up on my 13. However, the beta hasn't been without its issues. As a user of VoiceOver screen reader, I've noticed that most English or most US English voices no longer read emojis at all. I also experience the occasional Apple Music crash, specifically while playing music in the background. I'm curious if it's been background for anyone else, or it's mostly been while the app was running on the screen. I think it's mostly anytime. I don't think it really matters from what I'm hearing. The next one is from Tim Chisonis. Hopefully I'm saying that properly. I'm using an iPhone 8 that has a battery capacity of 100%, and I'm running iOS 16 Beta 3. The battery life on it is excellent. I'll go to bed with it unplugged at 100%, wake up 7 hours later, and it's still 100%. Can't wait until Beta 4. Chris Ramirez says, I've been running iOS 16 public beta the whole week on my iPhone 13 Pro Max and is working fine. Just the battery life is a little bit bad, not like iOS 15.6, which was great on battery. Jason Hutton said, voice dictation on email seems to get stuck and I can't get back to the keyboard. Like I mentioned, there's some little odd bugs here and there with dictation. Kareem Saloom says, iPhone 13 Pro Max on 16 Developer Beta 3, been solid for a beta. As long as you understand what a beta is, this is pretty good. A battery is definitely much worse, but the rest is good enough to run on a daily. And that's what I mentioned earlier. If you're thinking of installing it, just keep in mind it will be a little bit buggy and battery isn't great. Sarah Anderson said, my Bluetooth headphones don't connect with phone calls unless manually, and battery is taking a hit with this one. Personally, so far, not into 15.6 public beta on my iPhone XR. And this was one of the exceptions I saw with 15.6. It should be pretty good for most, so those are things you're going to have to look at settings for that hopefully will resolve that issue. But there's definitely some bugs still here and there for some, but it seems to be most stable for the majority. So that's everything with iOS 16 public beta 1 and beta 3 re-release, as well as iOS 15.6 RC2. Of course, I'll keep you informed as soon as I know when iOS 15.6 is out, and if you've found anything else I haven't mentioned, I'd love to hear from you in the comments below. If you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, of course, I'll link it in the description like I normally do, and if you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe, and if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.